Good morning, students. Today we are going to discuss the second chapter of class 9, physics, and that is force and law of motion. I hope you all are familiar with this very word in class 8, force. What is this force? Here I have written here definition: a force is a push or pull upon an object resulting from the object interaction with another object. It means one thing you should keep in your mind, and I hope you all know about that. Whenever there is an interaction between these two objects, then there is a force applied between them, or whenever this force applied over any object, then there is an interaction between the two objects. It means without interaction. Whenever we apply the force over another object, then there is an action applied by the object and there is reaction applied by the another object. Then this force applied over the another object. So there is an interaction between them, and that is known as force. This force is a vector quantity. This force is a vector quantity because this force has magnitude as well as its direction. Because whenever we are applying the force, it shows that who is applying the force over which object. It means we should always represent, and it is already represented with the help of arrowhead, that this force is applied over which object. That's why this force is a vector quantity. Now, the derivation for the force. This force is directly proportional to the mass of the object. If you increase the mass of the object, force increases. And if you increase the acceleration of the body, then force increases. So it is directly related to the mass and acceleration. You can also define this force. It is the product of mass and acceleration of the body, that is known as force. So when we release this proportionality, we got this F is equal to KMA. So finally, we got the formula F is equal to MA. One thing you should keep in your mind when you are solving this numerical, at that time, for the class 9, you should not take any tension, but for class 11, it gets changed. Suppose that if your mass is going to be changed with the time, or whether your acceleration is going to be changed, at that time you have to do differentiation or integration with this formula, then we will study in the higher class. So here you will only study that F is equal to MA. Here F is force of the object. So the finally we get the formula F is equal to MA. So what is here F? F is force, M is mass, and A is acceleration of the object. Force for B written F, mass, and acceleration. So F is equal to MA. What is the SI unit of the force? The SI unit of the force is here. The SI unit of the force is Newton. SI unit of the force is Newton, and which is denoted by letter capital N. We do not have to write on the quantity Newton, so we simply write on the capital N for denoting this SI unit of the Newton. And this force is measured in kg meter per second square. Kg meter per second square. That's why a single name is given for the regard of the Newton. So this kg meter per second square is known as Newton here. So the SI unit of the force is known as Newton. In class 8, you have already seen that these forces are classified into two groups, and thereby this all the forces are classified into two groups, and they are known as the contact force first, and second is the non-contact force. Contact force and non-contact force. What is this contact force? Contact forces are those forces where there is a physical contact between the action and reaction body. It means if there is a physical contact between the force of force and object, then that is known as the contact forces. And the examples are what? Muscular force is example of the contact force. Frictional force is example of the contact force. What is this non-contact force? Non-contact forces are those forces where there is not any physical contact between the source of the force and the object. It means if there is not any physical interaction between the object, then that is known as non-contact force. And the examples are what? Example simple, if you bring the one magnet near the another magnet, suppose that these are the two magnets, and if you bring near to each other, then there is no need to physical contact between them, and they will attract or whether they will repel. So they apply the forces over each other when they bring near to each other without any physical contact, so they are known as the non-contact force. Another example is also what? When you drop this chalk, when I drop this chalk, then this chalk get attracted by the ground. And this is what? This is the non-contact force, because this gravitational force applied by the earth over this very chalk without any physical contact. So that is known as non-contact force. One more thing you should keep in your mind, and you have already studied in class 8, that is, what are the effects of forces? If I go in this force, this is the force, then what are the effect of forces? Effect of forces are what? We have seen in the previous class the effect of forces. Because whenever this force word came in my mind or came in our mind, then one thing came in exist, that wherever this force applied over the object, this force always do some changes, bring some changes. Which type of changes? If the object is in rest, then if this object is in rest and I apply force over this very object, then many possibilities this object will come in motion. So first effect is what? The force bring a stationary object in motion. Another example is what? Another effect is what? If this chalk, if this body is in motion, if we apply the force from opposite direction of the motion, then we can bring this moving object in rest. If we apply the force along the direction of the motion, then we increase the velocity of the body. If we apply force opposite to the direction of the motion or sideward to the direction of the motion, we bring this object maybe in rest, maybe in motion, or it will change the direction of the motion. So what are the effects? The effect of the forces are, these all topics you have studied in the previous class, in class 8. So first, what are the effect of forces? First is what? It brings a stationary object in motion, first thing. Second is what? It stops the, may or may not, it's not sure that continuously whenever we apply the force, if the very less amount of force applied to the very heavy object, it may be possible it has come that object does not come in motion, but it can bring the object in motion. So here it has stopped the moving object. Third is what? It can increase or decrease the speed or velocity of moving object. Okay, it can increase or decrease the velocity of moving object. Next, it can change the direction. It can change the direction of moving object. It can change the direction of moving object. It can change the shape and size of the object. So these are the effect of forces. Now, basically, these are the topic of class 8. Now we are going to start the topic of class right? These all forces are classified into two groups, and they are what? They are known as the balanced force and unbalanced force. Balanced force and unbalanced force. What are this balanced force and what are this unbalanced force? Before this balanced force and unbalanced force, one more thing you should keep in your mind. Suppose that if this is any object and this object is shaped over any surface, and if this force applied from this direction, force applied from this direction. So in the previous topic, we have seen that this force is a vector quantity, and if it is a vector quantity, then it has its direction. So if one direction is applying towards this and another direction applying opposite to this, then these two forces, it is F1 and maybe it is F2, so this total forces become F1 plus minus F2. Reason what? Reason is that because one force and another force are acting opposite to each other, and when the two forces are acting opposite to each other, then they cancel each other. Okay, this thing you should keep in your mind. If the number of forces are applying along the same direction, then they will add it algebraically. So one thing for all the problems, one solution, and that is what? Force added algebraically. Force added algebraically. It means, just in algebra mathematics, you have seen that if you are adding the plus 2, minus 3, plus 4, minus 6, then we simply add it. If it is minus, then it gets subtracted. If it is plus, then it gets added. Here is a simple concept of the direction. So if the two forces acting along the same direction, the total forces added. If the two forces acting opposite to the direction, it gets subtracted. Okay, so come to the balance force. What is this balance force? If the balanced force are applied over the object, if the balanced forces are applied over the object, then object does not move. Then object does not move. That object will remain in motion. Reason what? Reason is that the sum of all forces acting over the object are zero. The resulting force is zero. Because in previous chapter, we have seen that if any object is in uniform motion, it means if the speed of the object does not change it with the time, it means there is not any forces are applying over that very object. So we also see here this balanced force and unbalanced force, and that is what we see here. Suppose that this is any heavy object, and this heavy object is kept over any hard surface. This heavy object is kept over the hard surface. So this is the hard surface. And this is any heavy object. Maybe this object is a heavy box. This is any heavy box. This is any heavy box, and if we are applying the force over this very object, so suppose that if this person is applying the force over this, pushing this object with a very high effort, if this person is pushing this object, so this force is known as force of our push. Yeah, applied force we can also write. And from this direction, we have studied in the previous chapter or in the previous class about the friction. And we know that this frictional force are always applicable opposite to the direction of the motion. So if we are applying the force over this object, then from another direction, frictional force is applied. So this is the force of friction. And these two forces, and whenever we apply the force over any another object, then simultaneously four different types of forces were applied, and they are If we are applying the force from another direction, frictional force from upward direction, it is the force of gravity. Force of gravity. This is the force of gravity acting downward. From downward direction to upward direction, it is the normal reaction. Normal reaction. It means one force, second force, third force, fourth force. What is this balance force? Once again, try to understand. Whenever we apply force over any another object, then simultaneously four different type of forces applied over that very object from different direction. And if sum of all the forces acting over this object is equal to zero, then that object is said to be in balance force. Then that forces are known as balance force. It means, suppose that, try to understand with the help of mathematical calculation. So this is what, suppose that from this very direction, if we are applying the force of 50 Newton, from this very direction, if we are applying the 50 Newton, and if this object does not move, if this object does not move, then in previous class we have seen that the static frictions are known as self-adjusting force. It means if this object does not move from this position, it means from opposite direction, also 50 Newton force there applied. From opposite direction, also 50 Newton force there applied. So from this direction 50 Newton, from this direction 50 Newton. So 50 minus 50, it gets cancelled. So both the forces, because they are acting opposite to each other, if the two equal forces are acting opposite to each other, then they cancel each other. Both the forces cancel each other. So these two forces cancel each other. Now, here it is written that this is a hard surface. This heavy box is kept on hard surface. So if this heavy box is kept on the hard surface, then that box does not going down or does not uplifting up. So these two forces are also equal. So sum of all the forces acting over this object is equal to zero. And if sum of all the forces acting over the object is equal to zero, then the forces are said to be balanced force. It means if any object is remain at their own position, so we can say that balanced forces were acting over that very object. You are sitting at their own places, it means balanced forces were applied over you. Otherwise, you continue float from one point to another point. So, for overall, one thing you should keep in your mind, balanced forces are those forces when there is a no motion. When there is no motion, then there should be balanced force. Or when there is a uniform motion, both condition you should keep in your mind. If there is uniform motion or if there is no motion, then the object is said to be in balanced force. Now the question here is this here, sir, how can we say that this uniform motion object are also said to be in balanced force? Yeah, we can say that, because if the forces were applied, then whether it can increase its velocity or whether it can decrease its velocity, but its velocity does not decrease. It means what? It means from both the direction no any forces were applied, or from both the direction same forces were applied, that's why the object will remain in their own position. So this is known as the balanced force. What is for the non-balanced force or unbalanced force? So here we can able to see for the unbalanced force. For the unbalanced force, we can see here is not very heavy. This frictional force is not very heavy. That's why this force of applied is more than the frictional force. Here, force of push is greater than frictional force. So the object is in unbalanced force. And whenever there is an unbalanced force where applied over the object, then object whether accelerate or whether decelerate. Whenever unbalanced forces were applied over the object, then object, if it is in rest, then it will come in motion. If it is in motion, then it will come in rest. Whenever unbalanced forces were applied, then. It means whenever unbalanced forces were applied, then object does not remain in uniform motion. It will whether accelerate or whether decelerate. But whenever there is a balanced forces were applied, then it will remain either in rest or either in uniform motion. So this is the complete theory for the balanced force as well as unbalanced force. The examples are what? I have given some example, the heavy boxes, almirah, freezers, refrigerator, and the gadgets, heavy gadgets are placed at their own places only due to the balanced forces. Unbalanced forces, vehicles running over the road, that is due to the unbalanced forces. If we are pushing any object, if we are pulling any object, that is the unbalanced forces. If we are flying the kite in the sky and the kite is at their own places, then there is a balanced forces were applied. By whom? By air and by thread. We are applying the force over the kite with the help of thread, and the air is applying the over the kite force in opposite direction. So both the forces are equal, so the kite remain at their own position. But if we cut up the thread, then the kite is not in your control. Reason what? Unbalanced forces were applied over that very kite. So this is the balanced force and unbalanced force.